What's up, guys? Pat here, hanging out at Dumps in Brooklyn for WCWP, Shred Shack Radio. We were hanging out with the guys from Halcyon Way. Guys, thank you so much for having us here, because we're here for the CD listening party for you guys tonight.
Thanks for being here, man. We
appreciate
it.
Yeah.
And thank you for pronouncing our name right.
Yeah.
There is that. That is good. It's not Halcyon. I know.
Have you gotten some bad pronunciations lately? Or?
Oh, God. Well, there's always
Halcyon.
Halcyon. That's a good one.
Halcyon.
What's another one?
Halcyon. That's a good one. That's a really good one.
Halcyon.
Yeah. No.
Just for the record, now that I know that you guys don't want it pronounced like that. So I'm here with Halcyon Way. This is my first time actually in Duff's. I live on Long Island. I've never been here. I feel like this is a rite of passage for metalheads to come here.
It is. It clearly is.
This is my first time here. John's been here a couple times. But,
I've been here four or five times, I guess.
I mean, for a frame of reference, you are currently doing this interview from a barber chair. You're currently doing it from an electric chair.
Correct.
And we're next to a couch that's shaped like a coffin. So
with leopard upholstery.
Yes. Well, because, you know, you got to style it up. Just because you're dead doesn't mean you have to have no class.
John, you need that for your house.
I do need that for my house.
Not that your house looks like a...
I feel like it,
like a morgue or anything. But
I mean, I feel like the leopard print kind of
makes it sassy.
I feel like it accentuates my feathered hair.
I'm actually like, I'm just walking through here and I'm just going like, I would take that, I would take that, I would take that if nobody was looking and I cared about my reputation.
Unfortunately, he somehow has like most of this like epoxy to the wall or something.
Yeah,
so you have to, because somebody would be here drunk and be like, dude, that's so cool. I like that.
I'm not lying. When I was in college, I used to be kind of a klepto. When I went to bars, I would have tried to take at least 10 things from this place.
I think you should try to walk out with that mannequin.
I didn't even notice that, but now that's on it's on the list. So there you go.
It should be. All
right, so we're here for the listening party for you guys' new album. It comes out in 2 weeks.
Yep.
And we've only got like snippets from it so far. A couple singles that have been released. A couple of videos have been made. We actually played Blame on the radio last night.
Thank you.
And I got to tell you, like, we had like a nice little like sing along moment at the end of the song where it all drops out and the chant keeps going, and we were just like, wait for it, wait for it. They got another one. So,
we knew we had a good song there because we were out on tour in Europe this past spring.
Yeah.
We brought that out, and
the crowd was singing it immediately.
Every show. You know, nobody knew it. I mean, we barely knew it. But it was that, so we knew we had something like really cool.
I mean, it's catchy as all hell, so I think it works. But as somebody who's kind of coming into you guys with kind of fresh eyes, like, would you say that that's a good representation of your sound as a whole? Would you say that it's completely different from the last album you put out? Or
I think it's a good, I think it's a good representation of what we do, because it's got you know, a lot of heavy thrashy riffs, a lot of double bass, it's got a breakdown, it's got a really super catchy chorus, a lot of vocal harmonies, death metal vocals, it's got a nice tasty solo, if I do say so myself.
Don't hurt your shoulders and pounding yourself on the back.
Yeah, I gave myself a little sprain right there. But don't worry, I mean, you know, I had to pro tool it.
I mean, I wouldn't have noticed if you hadn't said anything, but if you're gonna bury yourself, I'll at least put a couple layers of dirt on top of that, I guess.
All right, cool.
But
fair enough.
There you go.
A leopard print coffin.
That's the exact coffin.
Yeah.
So when you guys were actually producing this album, like what was in your mind that you wanted to do differently this time around? Because I know this is your first album in about 4 years.
Mm-hmm.
So when you guys actually like got into the studio, what was your mindset going into this?
We wanted it to be really heavy. And we wanted it to be, we wanted all the songs to be just mega catchy.
We struggled too.
We did. We worked really hard. The chorus of Blame actually got rewritten, I think, 4 times before we landed on something we were happy with. And when I say rewritten, I mean new chord progression, new riff, new vocals, new lyrics, the whole deal. It just changed several times before we felt like we nailed it. But we went into tracking the record, and I think we had 28 songs demoed out, so we pretty much had to have like a cage match between songs to figure out which ones we were gonna actually cut.
When it comes, I find like this is one of the things when you have so many tracks and you kind of have to kind of battle it out to see what fits. Are you in the mindset where you try to combine tracks, or you just put them off to the side for later use?
Usually the track will get pushed off to the side, you know, but sometimes we'll steal a riff out of one of them or whatever. I think that probably happened a couple times on this.
I know we tried to pull out one of the extra songs that we didn't really finish from Conquer. Mm-hmm. And we worked on it for a minute, and we're like, we just lost interest or something. I don't know what it was.
Yeah, it was a real cool demo that we had for Conquer. We pulled out the Pro Tools session, started working on it, and we were like, it doesn't fit with the rest of the material.
Yeah.
So we kind of like Steve says, we sort of lost interest in it. But I mean, you know, the main thing is that if the song doesn't have a huge chorus, if it doesn't have a really good catchy hook, then it's not going to make one of our albums. And so we killed a lot of tracks that had like killer riffs and like just super cool other stuff, but we couldn't quite get that chorus there, and that's pretty much what determined what we killed and what we kept.
So, of the tracks we're going to hear tonight, I actually am looking forward to hearing a lot of it, because I've been seeing a lot of build-up for it on social media, on your guys' Facebook page. I see this popping up like every couple of days where you got a bunch of different artists in this. Please explain to me, what is the Nailhead Choir?
Well, the Nailhead Choir is a group of, it's probably about 10 people that we have become friends with through touring and whatnot, and you know, we reached out to them. We said, hey, look, we want to do a big choir gang vocal deal. Here's the songs. Dude, do your thing.
You got so many people involved in that. You got members of like Iced Earth and like Pure Amaze on this.
Yep.
And, you know, I'm going to assume that you knew these people beforehand.
Yeah.
Okay.
They're all
friends.
Yeah, Jonah from Pure Amaze, he actually did some keyboards on our very first record 10 years ago.
Oh, nice.
So we've been friends for a long time. And then he and Matt Barlow were in Atlanta a year or two ago for some things. And they actually stayed with us, and we hung out. And then Matt sang his parts for the Nailhead Choir part. You know, we got K.K. Foster from them. Hopefully he's going to be out tonight, because he only lives about an hour from here. Hopefully he can make it. Got Ben from Galactic Cowboys, band that was a huge influence of mine for a million years. I love that band.
Yeah,
I mean, there is truth.
All the bands to be gay over. I mean, you know.
Hey, see, this guy gets me.
And Chimera.
Oh, that's preaching to the choir here.
See, we get each other.
There you go.
He met the drummer, and I thought there was going to be a relationship.
That wasn't the drummer.
Wasn't the drummer? No. Oh, he sold you a drum, the kick drum, though.
Yeah.
Yeah, but I thought there was going to be relations there.
So what happened was... No, like the guitar player from Chimera, after they had split up, I guess, had the one of the drum head, the kick drum heads from the Resurrection tour that they used on the tour, and I love that record. It's one of my favorite albums. And dude put it up on an eBay or something like that, and I bought it. And then we were in
Cleveland.
Yeah, we were in Cleveland.
Yeah,
we played Theo Gore, that's right. We're on tour Face Warning. And so a dude came out to the show, handed me the drum head, and I was like, woo!
He was like, oh. I don't blame him. Like, dude, how sad was it that day when you saw that graphic on their website that just said that they weren't going to tour anymore?
Right, exactly. Exactly. I actually wanted to go up to their Christmas show that they did, reunion show about 6 months ago, but just couldn't make it up there.
All right, well, getting back to you guys for a bit. when you guys, I don't know if you've done like a situation like this where you have a listening party for an album, but when you guys have a situation like this where you know you're going to just be kind of putting everything forward and just seeing what sticks, what do you guys want everybody to leave here tonight thinking, besides like, this is good and I want to buy this?
Well, we want the people that have heard
us.
Well, I mean, this is good, and we want to buy it here, take our money. We love that. But, I mean, really, you know, for the people that have heard us, we want them to go, oh, my God, this is an amazing new album. This is everything I wanted to hear from this band. For people that haven't heard us, they want to go, I want them to say, where has this band been my whole life? And that's really, I got high expectations.
Well, it's good to have goals, but, you know.
But, I mean, yeah, that's really our objective is if people haven't heard us before, we want to be fans after they walk out the door.
I got to tell you, like, because we've only heard a couple of tracks on our end. I'm really looking forward to hearing the rest of this album. So
thank you.
Be sticking around for this. I'm not just going to duck out as soon as we're done with the interview. Just go, like, talk to you guys now on the way. I'm going to go to the way station or something. But I just want to thank you guys for giving me the time to talk to me about this. We are really looking forward to the album, and we're going to be picking up a copy in 2 weeks when it comes out. And before we go, though, what we do for every band we interview is we just kind of give you guys like a lightning round, just some random ass questions off the top of our heads, and just don't even think about it. Just say whatever comes to your mind first, okay? There we go. Chicken or steak?
Steak.
Boxes or briefs?
Briefs. Boxer briefs.
Black Sabbath, Dio or Ozzy?
Dio.
Who would win an arm wrestling match, Lemmy or God?
Trick question, Lemmy is God.
Yes, it is. I love when bands see the movie Airheads. Okay. And finally...
Wait. Trivia about the movie Airheads.
Yes.
Galactic Cowboys are the band in that movie.
Yes, they are. They are the Sons of Thunder.
That's right. I actually ragged on Ben about that Indian... headdress thing you wore.
I actually brought it up when we interviewed them a couple weeks ago, and you could tell, like, he wanted to stare daggers into the phone and make my head explode.
Who was it doing the interview?
I don't remember, but
it
might have been, yeah. It was one of the most awkward and / amazing moments that I could have hoped for. Because I was like, this is exactly how I planned for this to happen. Why did I plan for this to happen like this? And finally, if the band was stranded on a desert island, which member would be eaten first?
Max.
Okay, I would have said Aaron.
There you go.
Yes.
All right. I love the gang mentality of it. Like, whenever I interview people, there are a couple of people who just go, like, it's probably me. Like, you know. But I prefer it when there's, like, animosity. Like, oh, definitely this guy. All right, Halcyon Way's new album is coming out in 2 weeks. We're here at Duff celebrating the listening party. Thank you guys so much for having us. Appreciate it.
Thank you, bro. We appreciate it.